Record. All right, so eyes are forward. Let's go. Pranayama breathing. Interlace all 10 fingers. Place the knuckles directly beneath your chin. Have the thumbs touching to your throat. All right, lock your knees. Pull the thighs up to the ceiling. And let's keep one point of focus throughout the whole practice. Okay, starting to exhale out any stale air. And begin to inhale, lift the elbows up. Inhaling for 1, 2. 3, lengthening, 4, holding it, 5, take another sip on 6, exhale, 6, look way back, 5, nice and loud, 4, exhaling, 3, 2, elbows touch away from the chest on 1, and let's inhale through the nose, breathing through the back of the throat, dragging the air into the body, saturating every single cell, stick your chest out, stretch the rib cage, suck the stomach in, hold it, exhale it out, dropping the head back. Make an audible HA sound, really tightening the core, squeezing out stagnation. Squeeze your palms, squeeze the elbows away from your chest. Inhale, chin down, eyes forward. Good, spread the elbows out wide. Press into the back of the knuckles and start to grow out of the crown of your head. Suck the belly in, hold it. Exhale it out, drop the head back. Stretch your eyes down the ceiling. Look for the farthest thing you can find. Squeeze your legs, palms, elbows touch away from the chest. Inhale, through the nose, chin down. Elbows spread, good. Press into the back of your knuckles. Start to lengthen up through the spine. Suck your stomach in, hold that. Exhale it out, dropping the head back. And each exhale is deeper than the previous one. Get out more air, create more space for new oxygen. Palms together, elbows touch away from the chest. Inhale through the nose, elbows spread wide. Good, press down through your feet to the floor. Lock your knees, lift your thighs up. Suck your stomach in, push the air into your lungs. Exhale it out. Dropping the head back, and we start to round your shoulders towards the again mirror in front of you. Squeeze your palms, forearms, elbows touch away from the chest. Inhale, chin down. Each breath, one right after the next one. Try to make them nice and fluid, nice and rhythmic. Suck your lower stomach in, stretch your rib cage, full lungs. Exhale it out, dropping the head back. And we suck your belly button to the base of your spine. Squeeze your gluteal muscles, palms, forearms, elbows touch away from the chest. Let's inhale for 1, 2, 3, 4. Stretch the rib cage. 5, take another sip, hold it on 6. Exhale for 6, 5, look way back. 4, suck the belly in. 3, keep exhaling. 2, elbows touch, hold it on 1. And let's inhale, spread elbows. Press the chin down, start to grow out of the crown of the head. Lengthen, get as tall as you can. Chin parallel to the floor, full lungs. Exhale it out, drop the head back. Make this the deepest exhalation so you're gasping for the next breath. Squeeze palms, squeeze everything out. Elbows touch away from the chest. Inhale, chin down, eyes forward. Squeeze your legs, squeeze your gluteal muscles. Suck your lower stomach in, stretch the rib cage. Take another sip, exhale from the top. Drop the head back, push the knuckles gently to the front of the throat. Good, relax shoulders, squeeze your palms, squeeze the elbows away from the chest. Inhale, chin down. Let's do 2 more of the biggest breaths you'll take all day long. Make them come naturally. Suck your lower stomach in, stretch your rib cage, stick the chest out, exhale it out. Drop the head back, get everything out, stale thoughts, toxins, tension, any impurities. Squeeze your palms, squeeze the elbows, belly in, inhale, chin down. Make this the best breath you'll take all day. Press into the back of your knuckles, stick your chest out, stretch the rib cage, taking a little bit more, full lungs. Exhale it out, drop the head back, look for the farthest thing you can find. Keep sucking your stomach in, squeeze your legs, squeeze your palms, forearms. Now squeeze everything out, elbows touch at the end. Change, good, lower the arms. So roll the head, the neck. All right, swallow a few times. We're gonna start right up into half moon. So finding that point of focus. Take the next inhale, arms rise over the head, palms touch. So let's interlace all 10 fingers, release the index, cross the thumbs. Biceps continuously touching to your ears, no gaps. Okay, squeeze your legs, keep continuous contraction of your thighs. Let's take the next inhale, lift up till touch the ceiling and start to bend your body down to your right and down to your left. Right, and just swaying each time through center, trying to create some lift, some length. We're gonna go left and right and then maybe forwards and maybe backwards. So you're gonna get full range of movement, all 4 directions working your spine. All right, bend your knees a few times, releasing any pressure, any popping, any cracking is good. Good, and let's come back and meet in the middle. So relock your arms, relock your legs. push the palms together, biceps glued to your ears. Press against the floor with your heels. Let's inhale, lift up, touch the ceiling, and bend your body down to the right. In an absolutely straight line without bending your elbows, without bending your knees. We're gonna push the hips out to your left, beyond flexibility, and begin to feel that stretch lengthening through your left side body. Pull your ribs in and down so your ribs are nice and knitted towards your spine, belly buttons in the base of your spine, and we have the weight pressing into the floor with your heels. Ankle bones towards each other, inner thighs towards each other. Let's go right shoulder forward towards the mirrors. Good, push the left hip forward towards the mirror. And now really suck the stomach in. Take an inhale, try to lift out of the waist, create length. And now exhale, come down, try not to fight gravity, push all the way. Push three, push two, push one. Good, inhale, come back to center. Take a new breath, reach up tall, touch the ceiling, and now bend to your left. And it's up, out of the waist. Over to the left side of the room, same setup. Without bending the elbows, without bending your knees. Continuously breathing in and out of your nose. Let's bring chin up away from the chest. Feel again, throat is open, your breathing passageway is clear, and we're focusing on the breath, we're not holding it. Feel the belly slightly moving with each breath in and out of your nose. Pull the rib cage down and in, suck your belly button to the base of your spine, and now start pushing against the floor with your heels. Let's bring left shoulder forward. And now push the right hip forward. Feel everything in alignment. Squeeze your palms. Take an inhale. Lift slightly up out of the waist. And now exhale. Come all the way down. Push. Push three. Push two. Push one. Inhale. Breathing. Come back to center. All right. So first backward bend. Drop the head right between the arms. Look for the farthest thing you can find. And it's just the head that's hanging back. So there's no curvature in the spine at all. Spine is completely straight. Take an inhale, lift your chest up, chest up, chest up. Keep the chest there. Now just pull arms back. Squeeze your palms, pull your arms back. Squeeze your palms, pull your arms back. Suck the belly in slightly. Press with your heels, hips forward. Now torso back. Dive way back. Stretch your fingertips to the back wall. Stretch the fingertips down. Look for the floor. Start to go back. Reach back. Stretch back. Look back. More back. Hold it. Change. Inhale, rise up. Suck the stomach in and exhale, forward fold. We're gonna go right down into Padukonstasana. Okay, first forward fold changes the energy from back bend to forward bend. So come down, separate your fingers, roll out your shoulders, relax your head, start to acknowledge the weight of your head. We're gonna keep it relaxed the whole posture. Okay, and the breathing is nice and slow through the nose. Let's go first set. Feet together, bend your knees. Place the stomach to the thighs, wrap the hands behind your heels, step underneath your heels. All right, if underneath the heels just isn't happening yet, grab to the sides of your feet. If you can get under your heels, bring your heels into your palms. Wrap the elbows behind your calf muscles, relax your head, exhale, breathing, roll forward, and begin to lift. And drive the hips up towards the ceiling, towards the sky. Continuously push your knees to the back wall. Good, lift your thighs up towards the ceiling, contract your quadricep muscles and start to pull the body down using your bicep strength. Pull on your heels, shoulders away from the ears. Good, push the stomach to your thighs, press the chest down to your knees. Now touch your forehead to your shins, finishing there. Roll forward, last chance, pull, lock your knees. Lock your knees, lock your knees. Change, good, palms together. Inhale, rise up, straight spine back to center. As soon as you get up there, find your eye contact and let's exhale, lower arms to your sides. Okay, practice complete stillness. Okay, notice your breathing, notice your posture. Let's do it again. Second set, inhale, arms up over the head, palms touch. Interlace 10, release the index fingers, cross the thumbs. Make sure when you bring the arms over your head, you don't stick the chest out, so ribs are down. Take an inhale, lift up, stretch up, and let's bend to your right. Let's come up out of the waist, reaching, stretching to the right side of your room without bending elbows, without bending knees. Notice if we're sticking the chest out or rib cage out. Pull the ribs down and in. Suck your belly button in. Good. Chin up away from the chest. Press against the floor with your heels and now push the palms together. Push the biceps to your ears. Come down. Suck your stomach in. Lock your knees. Come down. Push. Three. Push. Two. Push. One. Inhale. Come up. Okay, again, ribs down, inhale, reach up, bend to your left, come up out of the waist. You wanna feel this nice strong stretch through the right side of the body, reaching over to the left, keeping arms locked, knees locked. gluteal muscles are tight. Lower stomach sucks in. That's the whole center of the body. So belly is pulled in strong. Abdominal muscles are working. Chin up away from the chest. Palms together. Come down as you push. Try not to fight gravity. Get all the way down. Push three. Push two. Push one. Inhale through center. Keep the arms locked. Remember, make sure the spine is completely straight. We're just dropping the head back. Look for the farthest thing you can find. Squeeze your palms together. Take an inhale. Lift your chest up. Squeeze your palms. Pull your arms back. Lift your chest up. Squeeze your palms. Pull your arms back. Lift your chest up. Squeeze your palms. And now dive back. Look back. Reach back. Stretch back. More back. Go back. Reach back. Touch the floor. Take a breath. Hold it. Change. Inhale. Rise up. Nice, Karen. All the way up. Suck the belly in. And let's exhale, forward fold, and come all the way down the opposite way. Okay, so find the breathing. Second set, we don't really have much time to do a full warm-up again, so we're going to go right in, bend your knees, place the stomach to the thighs. We were just here before, so find that grip. It should be muscle memory now. All 10 fingers in the same direction as your toes. Stomach on your thighs, head relaxed. Suck your stomach in. Exhale, breathing, roll forwards and lift. Let's get right into it, stomach to thighs. Chest to your knees. If you can touch your forehead to your shins, hold it there the whole posture. Don't let it come apart. Push the knees to the back wall. Feel that stretch in the back of your hamstrings, the back of your Achilles, your kneecaps are stretching. Lift your thighs up to the ceiling. Pull the top of the head towards your feet. Last chance. Wrap your elbows tighter. Suck your stomach in. And now roll forward. Touch forehead to your shins. Hold. And release. Good. Palms together. Flat spine, inhale, rise up, stretch up to the ceiling, get as tall as you can. As you exhale, lower arms to your sides, find complete stillness. Okay, breathing through your nose. Let's go Utkatasana. Step the right foot out to the right, 6 inches apart. All 10 toes point forward. And we turn the big toes in just slightly, so the outsides of the feet are parallel. Let's inhale, the arms come up parallel to the floor. So arms in front of you, fingertips reaching to your shoulders. Take a nice deep inhale. Suck the stomach in, exhale, sit back into a chair. Let's bend your knees. So you're gonna bend your knees, maybe bounce a few times, try to put all the body weight back into your heels. As the weight comes into your heels, make sure all 10 toes are still actively pressing into your floor. Don't let the toes lift up. Relax your shoulders. Activate your tricep muscles, arch your upper body back. Last chance, suck your stomach in, try to bend your knees, sit back, fall back, go back, change. Inhale, relax your shoulders. Let's lift to your toes. So max them like a ballerina, all the way up on the big and the second toes, holding it there. Keeping everything as it is, just start to bend your knees. And we're gonna bend your knees, kick your knees up, kick your heels up. Lower the body down into that chair. You want thighs parallel to the floor, good, arms parallel to your thighs. And you're stronger than you think, so try to get right into your chair and hold it there. Triceps tight, suck your stomach in and kick knees up, kick heels up, three. Relax the shoulders, two, and lift up on one. Push all the way back to center. Nice, heels come down, let's do one more. Squeeze your knees together like you have one strong knee. Third part, lift up onto your toes just enough, and now start to slide down the back wall. As we slide down, squeeze your knees. Relax your shoulders. Notice your tricep muscles, make sure they're tight, they're engaged. Right before you're about to touch your heels, pause. Nice, Bob, putting on the brakes, squeeze your knees. Squeeze your knees, lift up a half inch, give a bounce if you have strong knees. And then on that last upwards bounce, let's inhale, rise up. Five, breathing. Four, three, two, and one. Heels down. Good. Feet together, arms to your sides, shoulders back, chin back, eyes forward. Let's go one strong set of eagle. Inhale, arms up over the head, palms together. We're going to exhale, swing the right arm under your left arm. Cross at the elbows, cross again at the wrists. Pull the elbows up and down a few times and try to make sure the arms are through the middle of the body, not off to one side or the other. All right, suck the belly in and let's sit down into your chair. So bend your knees. See how low you can sit. Press your heels down. Arch the upper body back and bring the right leg high up, over, and around. You want to stabilize that standing left leg. Press all five toes into the floor. Shift the body weight towards the heel and let's start to cross and twist your legs like ropes. We're going to find one point of focus in front of you. Bring the chin up away from the chest and start to lean your upper body back. Stack your shoulders above your hips. Twist your knees once to the right, upper body once to your left, Now squeeze tighter, sit a little bit deeper, hold at the end. Change, that's it. Take a full inhale, arms overhead, palms touch. Exhale, swing the left arm under the right arm. So cross the elbows, cross once more at the wrists, pull the elbows up and down, side to side. Try to get the wrists straight with each other. Okay, cross, interlace the fingers or palms together, thumbs crossed. Suck the belly in, let's sit down into your chair. Same thing, bounce a few times, see where your lowest point is, hold it there. Arch the upper body back, bring your left leg high up, over and around. Point the toes, cross, wrap, twist your legs like ropes. If you fall out, it's normal, just get right back into it. And wherever you are, look for one point of focus. Not thinking so much of the depth of the posture, but being able to just hold it where you can. And then once you have that stability, twist your knees just very slowly, once to the left, upper body once to the right. Squeeze tighter, sit a little bit deeper, lean back at the end. Change, beautiful. Inhale, fill the lungs, arms overhead. On your exhale, lower the arms to your sides at your own pace. Keep one point of focus on you. Notice your breathing. All right, see if you want to grab that sip of water. If you need it, grab it. If not, stay with your meditation. Just keep that one point on you. All right, breathing through your nose is that continuous moving meditation. And we're going to start right back into the balancing series. All right, so once you're ready, come back in. Big toes touch, heels touch. Set your intention for the next few postures. If you fall out, again, just keep coming right back into it. Let's start standing head to knee. Left leg locked, solid, flat to the floor. And all together, inhale, right leg lifts up. Okay, right leg up, suck the stomach in. Let's interlace all 10 fingers and round down, find a grip underneath your foot. Okay, including your thumbs with your grip, all 10 fingers. And once you have that grip, look straight ahead for your standing leg into the mirrors. Okay, wherever you are, you're on one leg. The leg is locked, solid, concrete. You want to feel that contraction of your standing quadricep by pushing your knee back, lifting the thigh up towards the ceiling, and continuously keep that quad active. Bring the weight forward by bringing your hips over your standing ankle. And if you have that full grip, your leg is not moving, shaking, or wobbling, let's take that next inhale and start to kick right leg out and forward. Kick and extend, and it's a slow, controlled kick. Heel lines with hip, parallel to the floor. Both legs locked, both elbows locked, pull the elbows down. As the elbows pull down, the leg stays exactly where it is. Don't let it drop any lower. Keep the toes pointing straight up to the ceiling. And now pull the wrists into each other. Suck your stomach in and kick 3, 2, and release on 1. So re-straighten the elbows back to center. Right leg comes down. Shoulders back, chin away from the chest. Breathing through your nose. Let's go right leg locked, inhale, left leg comes up. So second side, left leg lifts, thigh parallel, flex all 5 toes. So we start that 60 seconds as soon as the leg lifts up. So let's suck the belly in, round it, and find a grip. 10 fingers down beneath your foot, including the thumbs with your grip. Now again, if the foot's not happening today, grab somewhere else. Grab to your shin, reach for your knee, or just stay there with the leg lifted, as long as you're on one leg. Working towards something, building the strength of the standing leg. The standing quadricep stays contracted consecutively for as long as it can. Now watch yourself into the mirrors, bring both hips forward like you're stacking your hips back above your ankle, more weight shifts into the toes. And if that leg is still solid, concrete, take the next inhale and let's kick left leg out and forwards. Kick and extend through the heel, stretch out the back of the kneecap, keep the ankle on straight, 2 again, hips and ankles in one line, and now bend the elbows down beneath your calf muscle. Second part, pinch the elbows to the sides of your calf, pull the wrists in closer, and now relax your shoulders. Kick, 3, 2, and release it on 1. Beautiful, so the elbows go straight, leg back to center, bring the hands to your low back, and let's just let that go. So push the hips forward, drop the head, look way back, go back. Okay, and you're right back to just that one point of focus. Try not to let anything around you distract you. Let's do it one more time. So left leg is locked. And let's go right leg lifts up. So we're going to have 30 seconds, half the time. Suck the belly in. Let's exhale, round down. Find a grip. 10 fingers down beneath your foot, including your thumbs with your grip. You got it. Once you have that grip, look straight ahead for yourself into your mirrors. Make sure your leg is not moving, shaking, or wobbling. Let's take the next inhale and start to kick right leg out and forwards. You're going to kind of move at your own pace. You're going to kick if both legs are locked out, both elbows are locked out. Let's pull the Elbows down beneath your calf muscle. Pinch the elbows to the sides of your calf. From there, round your back up. Tuck the chin and now touch your forehead to your knee. We try to touch exact forehead to knee. Maybe hairline to knee. And if you have it, holding, kick. Three. Relax the shoulders, two. And releasing on one. Beautiful. Really nice job. Come out step by step. Toes and feet together. Shoulders back. And same thing. Last side, last set. 30 seconds. Push the weight to your right leg. Let's inhale. Left leg comes up. Thigh parallel to your floor. Okay. Flex all five toes. Suck the belly in. And let's round down. Find a grip. 10 fingers down beneath your foot, including the thumbs with your grip. Okay. The closer we can interlace the thumbs with each other in the grip, the more likely we're going to hold the grip as we kick. So try to really get the thumbs interlaced with each other. Take a nice inhale and start to kick. Left leg out and forward. Kick and extend through the heel. Flex all five toes. Move at your own pace. If both legs are locked, pull the elbows down. Squeeze the elbows into your calf. Shoulders back. Round your spine. Tuck your chin. Touch your forehead to your knee. Stabilize your hips, your inner thighs. Suck your stomach in for balance. And touch the forehead to your knee. Hold. Three. Two. And releasing on one. Nice, Laura. Nice, Dan. Really good. Come out the opposite way, taking your time. Left leg comes down. Bring the hands to your lower back. Push the hips forward. And let that go. Drop the head. Look down your back wall if that feels good. Okay, and just coming back. Let go of each previous posture. Starting new posture, standing bow point pose. So 60 seconds. Let's take the right arm out. Palm facing up towards the ceiling. Bring the arm out to the side. And now drop that right arm down. Grab at the inside of the right ankle. All right, squeeze your knees together. Make them touch. Let's point the foot that's in the hand. Lift the left arm up, palm facing forwards. Chin up nice and tall away from the chest. All right, the most important thing is to keep a continuous stretch on your left side body. Let's inhale, lift up, stretch up. And now start to kick. And continuously kick that foot back into your hand. Kick into your fingers, lengthen out of your lower spine. Kick back, reach. Left arm forward in front of you. And we're moving really slow. We have a full minute. So we're slotting that left shoulder across the face. The shoulder goes right beneath your chin, fingertips to your eyebrows. Body comes down with the help of your kick. Now suck your lower stomach in and relax the right side of your back. Drop that right hip down even a millimeter and start to really kick from the right gluteal muscle. We have 10 seconds to be here, kicking, reaching, stretching in opposite directions. 5 seconds, body down, reach forward. Now kick straight up. Kick three, two, and one. Kick to come out. Nice, Patrick. Feet together, arms to your sides, practicing stillness, especially stillness with where you're looking. Try not to look around. Let's do a second side, left arm out, palm facing up towards the ceiling. Okay, so drop the left arm down, grab back at the inside of your left ankle. All right, squeeze your knees together. Let's bring the right arm up, palm facing forwards, chin up nice and tall away from the chest. So focus on the length of the right side of your body throughout the whole posture. Take an inhale, reach, create the length, keep it, and now start to kick the left leg back and away. And the kick is important, but same, so is the length. So keep that right arm reaching, stretching you forward. Left arm gets pulled behind of you. We start to get two shoulders reaching, stretching into one strong straight line. Kick the foot into your fingers, stretch out of your lower spine, and suck your stomach in. Keep your, again, abdominal muscles nice and tight. Body comes down slow, slide the shoulder across the face, bring the shoulder under your chin. And now we have these next 12 seconds to breathe in, breathe out of your nose, fingertips to your eyebrows, bring the shoulders down to your hip level in the mirrors. And now last few seconds, body down, reach forward, kick. Three, kick. Two, kick, one, kick to come out. Nice, Maria, feet together, take your breath. Okay, we get to do it one more time. So second set's 30 seconds, half the time. Okay, maybe focusing on something different. Let's go right arm out, palm facing up towards the ceiling. Let's drop the right arm down, grab back at the inside of the right ankle. All right, left arm up, palm facing forwards, chin up away from the chest. So we wanna try to keep connection the whole time. Take an inhale, reach up, stretch up, lengthen, and now exhale, start to kick. Right leg back and away, kick back. Shoulder with the chin. Slide the shoulder across the face, reach the fingertips between the eyebrows, stretching, reaching, kicking the body in opposite directions. As you kick, start to lower the body down. Let's try to get all the way into it. So right now, try to come into your maximum point. Let's see if we can hold it there for 10 seconds. Come into your maximum point. Standing leg is strong, quadricep contracted. Now reach and kick. 3, 2, and 1. Beautiful. Kick to come out. Try to create stillness as quick as you can. Even if you fall out, just get right back to your center point. 1 point on you, and let's go left arm out, palm facing up towards the ceiling. Let's do it one more time. Last side, drop the left arm down and back. Grab at the inside of your left ankle. Squeeze your knees together, right arm up, palm facing forward, chin up away from the chest. Right, so last side, last set. See if you can get right into your maximum and try to hold it there the majority of the time. Let's inhale, reach up, stretch up, and exhale, start to kick back. And kick back and bring the body down all at the same time. Kick back, bring the body down. Kick back, reach forward, slide, shoulder across the face. Keep the head on straight, shoulder beneath your chin, fingertips to your eyebrows, and now come to your maximum point. Suck your stomach in, nice Karen, fingertips to your eyebrows, and now body down, reach forward, nice bob and kick. 4, 3, go to your standing split, 2, kick, kick, kick. 1, and kick to come out, nice, feet together. Take a big step, let's go to the back of the mat. So let's start 10 second posture, start to really increase the heart rate. We're gonna go right into it. Twirl into Nindasana, inhale, arms up over the head, palms together. So we interlace all 10. So we're gonna go balancing stick first, Maureen. So go back, face forward to that mirror in front of you. Yeah, feet and toes together. Feet together, inhale, reach up, stretch up, and let's go right foot forward, big step, balancing stick. Lock both knees, now charge. Body down, leg up. Capital letter T. Body down, leg up. Chin away from the chest. Look 4 feet in front of you, holding. 9, 8, 7. Belly in. 6, 5. Stretch. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice. Step the right foot to your left foot. Stay nice and tall. Let's inhale, reach up. Left foot forward, big step. Lock both knees, balance. Go for it. Charge. Body down, leg up, right into it. 10 fearless seconds. We're gonna count it. 2 hips in 1 line, 2 shoulders in 1 line. Holding it. 9, 8, breathing. 7, 6, belly in. 5, look forward. 4, stretch. 3, 2, and 1. Nice, Maureen. Toes and feet together. Exhale, lower the arms. Okay, notice the breathing, notice your heart rate. And let's just go ahead to quarter turn. So let's come to the back left corner of your mat. Now we're gonna face that opposite wall. Okay, back left corner, standing separate leg stretch. I'm gonna start with the next inhale, bring the arms up over the head, palms together. All right, we're gonna step the right foot out, big step to the right, 4 feet, arms down parallel. So arms in a capital T. So keep facing that side wall, arms in a capital T, standing separate leg stretching first. So turn the body back forward. Inhale, stretch the arms back, lift the chest out, and exhale, start to dive forward. So we're gonna swan dive all the way down. So Maureen, just go back to center. Yeah, that one first, perfect. All right, when you get close enough to the floor, bend your knees just slightly and see if we can find a grip around the outsides of your heels. Okay, outsides of your feet, outsides of your heels. Once you have that grip, start to feel stretching through the legs. Hamstrings are opening, back of your knees, your calves, your Achilles. Once the legs begin to stretch, we want to start to stretch your spine. So from the coccyx to your neck, we pull straight down until the spine is perpendicular to the floor. So you have your grip, let's start pushing your knees back. Good, lift your thighs up and now close the gap between your stomach and your thighs. Compress, compress the body in half, roll forwards, now pull. If you have it, pull right down, touch your hairline to the floor. Let's change, arms back, inhale, rise up as smooth as you can, come back to center. Step both feet together. Arms over your head, palms touch. Exhale, lower arms to your sides. Okay, moving into triangle. Let's inhale, arms up over the head, palms touch. Okay, big step. Right foot steps out to the right, 4 feet. Arms down parallel into a capital T. All right, let's turn the right toes out 90 degrees. Tuck the left toes in slightly. Push both hips forward and begin to bounce. And bend into your right knee. Let's get that right thigh down there parallel to the floor. Ankle beneath your kneecap. We're gonna pause, pull both arms back. Flip the palms and now rotate the arms. Let's go right elbow to your right knee. Elbow to your knee, fingertips reaching towards that space between the big and the second toes. Left arm above your right arm. So you have two arms, like two arms and a clock, 6 o'clock and 12 o'clock. And we're pulling apart the chest, the lungs, the rib cage is opening. Swivel the chest open towards the ceiling by leaning the upper body back. Let's press into the outer edge of that left foot. Good, lock out your left knee. Tighten your left gluteal muscle, suck your stomach in, and now touch the chin to your shoulder as you look up, reach up, touch the ceiling, change. Inhale to reverse. Turn the right toes in, pivot your left toes out. Okay, press both hips forward, and let's go ahead to start to bend and bounce into your left knee. Okay, pause at the bottom. Make sure the hips are nice and straight. Pull both arms back, flip the palms, and rotate the arms. Let's go left elbow to your left knee. Now the left arm comes down, reach the fingertips towards the space of the big and the second toes. The right arm goes directly above your left arm. So one arm at 12 o'clock, one arm at 6 o'clock, opening, lengthening your lungs, your heart, your chest, again, stretching apart the space between your rib cage. Let's press into the outer edge of your right foot. Lock out that right knee, tighten your right gluteal muscle. Now touch the chin onto the shoulder, look up, inhale, reach up, stretch up, touch the ceiling. Change, and that's it. Take a big step, feet together, arms up, reach up, lengthen to the ceiling, exhale, lower the arms down sides. Okay, doing everything as gracefully, as slow as you can. Okay, back into that same nice strong position, and let's do it one more time. Second set, triangle. Inhale, arms over the head, palms touch. And let's step the right foot out to the right. Big step, 4 feet, arms come down parallel. Turn the left toes in, turn the right foot all the way out. Right, arms down, capital T. Second set, triangle. Bend into the right knee, bounce and bounce, get that right thigh down there parallel to the floor. Pull both arms back, flip the palms, and rotate the arms. Let's go right elbow to your right knee. Suck your stomach in, twist your upper body back. Try to keep some lift out of that right hip crease. Try not to sink too deep into that hip crease. Lift up through the left arm towards the ceiling. Press into your right toes, sit a little bit lower, and now push the elbow against the knee. Twist the upper body back, and now touch the chin to the shoulder. Reach up, stretch up, change. That's it. Nice job. Turn the right toes in, pivot the left toes out, press both hips forward, and let's bend. Let's bounce into your left knee. Get all the way down, get that left thigh parallel. Keep the belly in, don't let the belly push out. Pull both arms back, flip the palms, and rotate the arms. Last side, last set. Left elbow to your left knee. Fingertip to fingertip, lengthening the lungs, the chest, opening, again, stretching that space between your ribs, your intercostal muscles. And now touch the chin to the right shoulder, creating that nice strong tourniquet effect into the throat and the neck. Let's lock out your right leg. Good, tighten your right gluteal muscle. Look up, inhale, now reach up, lean the upper body back at the end. Change. Big step, feet together, arms overhead, palms touch, reach up. And exhale, lower the arms down sides. Okay, we're gonna do, okay, last posture facing this way. Take an inhale, arms up over the head, palms together, cross just your thumbs. Okay, standing separate leg, stretching forehead to knee. Step your right foot out to the right. Okay, pick up, all 10 toes, turn, pivot on the toes, face the back wall. All right, push your left hip forward, get two hips in one line. Take an inhale, reach up, tuck your chin to your chest, and exhale, roll over your front leg. Suck your stomach in, into your spine. Slowly come down to the floor. Nice. Once you get close enough, feel free to bend up your front knee as much as you need. Bend up your front knee until you can touch your forehead to your kneecap. And you want to feel that throat choking sensation. Suck your stomach in, push through your fingertips, bring your forehead or your hairline higher onto your kneecap, onto your thigh as you hold. Okay, keep your two hips leveled, both hands come back together, balance in prayer. Push your left hip forward, inhale, rise up using your core strength. Left hip forward. Good, touch the ceiling, chin off the chest last. Let's pick up the toes, turn, pivot. Turn again, pivot, face now the opposite wall. Perfect, push the right hip around and forward. Take an inhale, reach up, stretch up, tuck your chin. Pull the ribs back and now curl your body into a ball. Keep pushing your right hip down and forward. All right, slowly coming up and over your front leg. Bend up your front knee, touch your forehead to your knee. You want to be able to hold it in this discomfort for as long as you can, throat choking. Okay, eyes are open, breathing small, shallow breaths, breathing in, out of your nose. Suck your stomach in, touch your forehead, maybe touch your hairline to your knee if you have it, hold that. And now bring both hands back together in prayer. Straighten both legs, push your right hip around and forward, and let's inhale, rise up, right hip forward, forward, forward. Good, touch the ceiling first, chin off the chest last, and let's turn, pivot, both feet together, exhale, arms to your sides. So full breath in, out of your nose. We're gonna go ahead just to turn back and now face the front wall you began at. So facing that front mirror, maybe it's your TV, whatever it is. We have toes and feet touching skin on skin, and let's move into tree following into toe stand. So left leg is locked. Let's inhale, the right leg comes up. So we're gonna take the right hand to your ankle, left hand to the inside of your foot. Pick the heel up towards the belly button. Drop the knee down slow. And if that foot stays in its highest position, it's not going to slip or move a millimeter. Let's move the right hand first to the center of the chest, and then maybe the left hand meets the right hand. If we have the balance from here, toe stand, look 4 feet in front of you, and start to hinge. We're gonna hinge slowly down from the waist. If you'd like to practice for toe, just look 4 feet to the floor in front of you. Okay, hinging down, reach all 10 fingers to the floor, lean into the arms, bend into your left knee, and now sit on top of the heel in the center of the body, both hands to the sides of you for balance. And it's just trusting yourself, find that weightlessness. We're gonna go left hand, right hand, namaskar. And the balancing is gonna be a lot of core strength, so your core is tight. Find your stillness, look back to yourself in the mirrors, and once you're here, lift off the heel, hold. Good, now tree, stay strong. Really good, come out the opposite way, toe. Push up into your standing tree, meet those patiently waiting in tree. Good, find your eye contact and let's change. Right leg comes down. So shake out the right leg a little bit. Let's do one more time, left side, right leg locked. Inhale, left leg comes up. So left hand to the ankle, right hand to the inside of your foot. And do what you need to do to have this posture feel correct for you. So pick the foot up a few times. Maybe bring your knee forwards and then down. If the foot stays, it does not slip. Let's move the left hand first. Maybe the right hand meets for namaskar. Okay, toe stand, whatever you do on one side, do it on the other side. So once you're ready, look 4 feet in front of you. And let's start to hinge. And as you hinge, come down. Look 4 feet in front of you, hinge down, reach the arms in front. If you fall out, just go right back in. I'm gonna grab the floor, bend into your right knee. You got it, sit down on top of the heel. And once you're on the heel, bring the hands to your sides. Now point the left toes, the foot that's in your hip crease. It's always pointed, it's active. Left hand, right hand, namaskar. Engage your core, look forward, lift off the heel. If you have that balance, holding it. Beautiful, now tree, stay nice and strong. And toe, let's come right back up. Take your time, don't feel rushed. Come back into your standing tree. You find your eye contact and all together, let's change. So left leg comes down, release it, seal out your standing practice, however you choose. All right, and let's turn on. So let's flip right onto your back. Try to make this as smooth as you can. This is gonna be our next posture. So we're gonna lie right back into Savasana. Okay, feet face the back wall, head towards the mirrors, palms face up towards the ceiling. Okay, and as soon as you lie back, just starting to acknowledge if there's anywhere that you're holding any tension from any previous posture, okay, physically or even emotionally, if you're thinking about any previous posture, to let everything go, right? Starting fresh, coming back to your breathing, okay? Lengthening the breath, deepening your breath, breathing through your nose. All right, so you have your heels together, toes fall wide open, arms to your sides, palms face up to the ceiling. Okay, so let's blink the eyes a few times. Move your fingers, move your toes. All right, and let's start into Pavanamuktasana. Let's go toes and feet touch, side by side, tuck the chin slightly towards the chest. So you're looking for your toes. Let's inhale, that right leg comes up. Bend the knee into the chest, interlace all 10 fingers, include your thumbs. Let's take the knee out to the right. All right, avoid the rib cage, start to pull down, pull right into that shoulder at your deepest position, holding it there. Tuck the chin towards the chest, relax that left shoulder blade, left elbow back down to the floor, and take the next inhale to breathe, create strength. On the exhale, pull, 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 pull. Release. Right leg down, let it go. Let's inhale, left leg up, bend the knee into the chest. Same setup, maybe interlace the hands the opposite way you did the first time. Take the knee out to the left, avoid the rib cage, and now start to pull down and in to your left shoulder. Tuck the chin down into the chest, and now roll the right shoulder blade back down to the floor. Bring the right elbow straight against the side of the torso, bring the right elbow to the floor. And now inhale, and exhale to pull, 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 pull. Release. Left leg down. Let's do third final part, inhale, lift up both legs, bend the knees into the chest. Wrap the arms around your knees. Grab the opposite way you normally do. If you don't normally alternate, alternate now, create some balance. Once you have that nice strong grip, keeping the head down, tuck the chin. So tuck the chin as much as you can so that we can start to feel the back of your neck pressing against the floor. Constriction in the front side of your throat. Okay, shoulder blades relaxed down, middle back, lower back, tailbone to the floor. Take a nice inhale, squeeze your knees, exhale, try to lengthen just a little bit more, flatten the spine. And let's release both legs out. All right, we start with a very strong sit-up. So let's flex feet, arms up, cross the thumbs, tuck the chin, nice deep inhale, breathing, and quickly sit up, dive. Straight for the toes, double exhale. And as smooth as you can, let's flip right to the stomach. So belly flat, feet to the back wall, head to the mirrors. We go hands right to the sides of you. So palms are flat, you wanna get every finger pressing actively against the floor. Right, so zip your legs together, lock your knees, point your toes for Cobra, Bhujangasana. So to zip your legs together, take a nice deep inhale, breathing first, look up, and now lift. And we're gonna peel the body off the floor using 100% back strength. Make sure your knees are still locked. Press down from the tops of your feet, relax your shoulders. Now push with your thumb and your index fingers. Push until there becomes a little gap in between your elbow crease. Push shoulders down, look up, inhale, lift up, come up, go up, hold it there, take a breath, look for the wall behind you. Change, slowly come down. All right, bring the left ear to the floor, look to the right. Arms to your sides, palms face up. Deep inhale, deep exhale. All right, second set, chin away from the chest. Bring the hands to your sides, zip the legs together, pinch the elbows in nice and tight. So we do want to try to get into new areas of the spine, especially since we've all been practicing for a while. So if the elbow crease is still closed, push until it opens. Zip your legs together, take a nice inhale, breathing, look up. Now first lift up using 100% back strength. Back strength, lift up, come up, go up. Pull the chin back, look up with your eyes. Now pushing small increments with the palms until the elbow crease begins to open. Push down with the tops of your feet. Now lift up, break the belly button off the floor, hips off the floor, head back, look up, inhale, lift up, come up, go up. Change, nice, slow on the way down. Beautiful, look to the left. Right ear flat to the floor. Next posture is going to be up into the upper spine for locust. Let's just chin away from the chest. Take both hands, flip the palms over, bring the hands underneath you. You want to get the arms as close as they can get until one day the sides of the elbows will touch. Pinky fingers touch, all 10 fingers spread out. Now take the chin, lengthen it as far as it can go away from the chest. Let's relax the left, lock the right leg, stretch it back and lift up, holding. 10, 9, right leg, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Right leg down, lock the left, stretch it back, inhale, lift it for 10, 9, 8, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Left leg down. Tuck the chin, kiss the floor, zip your legs together like you have one strong tail. Feel your shoulders have the weight. Inhale and exhale, lift up. 10 seconds, locking your knees, both legs, pointing your toes and pushing that weight forward, forward into your shoulders. Remember, use your abdominal strength. Tighten your lower abdominal muscles. Lift up, come up, go up, change. Good, slowly come down. And it's from complete work to complete relaxation. So look to your right, left ear flat to the floor. Okay, especially when we're working your spine, breathe into your back muscles. Don't let them become too tense or tight. Let's do it again. Second set, chin away from your chest, locust. Both hands flip, bring the palms underneath you. Spread out all 10 fingers as wide as you can. Second set, we always get into it just a little bit more smooth. We know where to go. Let's relax the left. Lock the right leg, stretch it back, and now lift up right leg, 10 seconds, half of 90, 45 degrees. Make sure again that right hip is pushing down into your right wrist. Press with your shoulders, lift up, come up, go up, change. Right leg down, let it go. Lock the left leg, stretch it back, lift up, 10 seconds. Locking the knee, pointing the toes. Keep trying to touch an imaginary button on the back wall, lengthen out, and now lift up, come up, go up, change. Left leg down, tuck the chin, third final part, last one, zip your legs together. Okay, imagine you have one strong tail, your tail does not bend or separate. Take a nice deep inhale and exhale, lift up both legs off the floor, holding it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, exhale, 5, 4, holding, 3, lift up, 2, lift up, 1, slowly come down, happens all the time. Look to the left, right ear flat to the floor. Okay, deep inhale, deep exhale. Okay, moving into the next posture. So let's go full locust, chin away from the chest. Arms out to the sides like airplane wings. So arms are out, palms are flat. Zip your legs together, lock your knees, point to your toes. Press the hips firm into your floor. All right, let's go full locust. Take an inhale, breathing first, look up, and now lift up. Everything comes off the floor, arms, legs, head, chest, rib cage off the mat. Pull the chin back. Again, we're making a slight double chin. Head goes back in between your shoulders. Legs up higher, lock your knees, point your toes, arms up, lift up, look up, come up, change. And let it go. Nice, Maureen. Look to the right, left ear flat to the floor. Okay, second set, chin away from the chest. Let's go again, arms out, capital T. Okay, we want the two hip bones to be the axis of the body. Everything else one day is gonna lift off the floor. So take a nice deep inhale, push your hips down, look up and lift up. Everything comes off the floor, push your hips down, lift your legs up. Get your thighs off the floor, chest, belly button, rib cage off the mat, fingertips over the top of your head. Don't hold your breath, but breathe in, out of your nose, legs up higher. Arms up higher, chin back, head back, lift up, come up, go up, change. Nice, Karen, exhale on the way down, look to your left, right ear flat to the floor. And last posture is gonna be floor bow, so chin away from the chest. And let's bend up both knees. Grab from the outsides of your feet, rest the pinky fingers right beneath the crease line of your toes. And once you have that grip, bring your knees together. Relax the shoulders, press the hips down. Take a nice deep inhale, and on the exhale, kick. Both legs off the floor. Kick back, kick back, kick back. Allow the kick to lift your chest, your heart off the mat. Draw the head back between your shoulders. Now look for your toes continuously until you see them over the top of your head. Roll forward onto the soft part of your belly. Now kick from your gluteal muscles. Kick from your thighs. Drop your head back. Look up, kick harder, kick higher. Change. Nice. Nice dance. Slow on the way down. Look to your right, left ear flat to the floor. Okay, one day really feeling this in that middle back, upper back, shoulders, definitely thighs. Second set, chin away from the chest. Bend up your knees. Let's do it again. Grab from the outsides of your feet. Pinky fingers rest right at the same spot beneath the crease line of your toes. Press the hips down, take a nice deep inhale and right into it, exhale, kick. Both legs off the floor, we kick back and kick up. and see if you can kick as much as you possibly can. Kick harder than you normally do. Kick harder, kick higher. Pull the head between the shoulders. Look for the toes behind of you. And now don't hold your breath. Exhale, deflate your belly, roll onto it, kick up. Drop the head back, roll forward, roll forward, roll forward. Now kick, kick, kick. Change. And release. Nice, Maria, and relax. Look to the left, right ear flat to the floor. All right, let's go hands down. Push right up into that high plank position. Come off the floor. Use whatever you need to get up. Push back into a down dog if that feels good. All right, do a few push-ups if that feels good. Nice, and we're holding. We're gonna come all the way up, look forward, come to the top of the mat for fixed frame. So it's coming all the way up, bring our knees together, spread the feet out just enough, and let's try to get right into it. So first and only set. All right, hips on the floor, feet point exactly to the wall behind of you. Once you're ready, start moving into it at your own pace. So you're gonna bring both hands onto the soles of your feet if we don't need them to the sides. Okay, hands to the soles of the feet, fingers face forward, and start to move one elbow, one forearm down at a time. Press the forearms down, prop the chest up. Maybe feel a popping or a cracking in that middle spine, opening the heart. And if the back of the head can touch the floor, tuck the chin, press the shoulders down. Let's go arms over your head. Grab the opposite way you normally do. Bring the knees a millimeter closer, half of a millimeter closer, whatever you can do. Feel more pressure in your knees, your ankles. And wherever you're at, take a nice deep inhale. Nice deep exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more. Exhale to the very bottom. And inhale, bring both hands back to the feet. So push up through the chest, come up, come forward, put both hands in front of you. Step or jump your feet back. I'm gonna go into that high plank. If high plank doesn't feel good, maybe down dog. And if neither of those feel good, just sitting and waiting into that next posture. So we're gonna hold, suck the lower stomach in. Okay, get that blood flowing all the way back down towards the knees, towards the feet. All right, now looking forwards, let's go drop down onto your knees. Sit back onto your heels, knees and feet together, half tortoise. Inhale, arms up over the head, palms touch. Cross the thumbs, inhale, reach up, stretch up, suck the stomach in, and let's exhale, fold forward. So slowly come down like a table. Taking your time on the way down, squeeze your palms, squeeze the biceps towards the ears. Let's get the tip of your nose and the center between your eyebrows to the floor. Okay, press your palms together. Let's inhale, crawl forward with the pinky sides of your hands. Walk one by one by one. And now push the pinky sides of the fingers down. Try to push your towel and mat away from you. Push down and forward, push your hips back. Inhale to stretch and lengthen forward. Exhale, push the hips back. Now tighten your core, prepare to come up. Let's lift up half inch off the floor, squeeze your knees, tighten your core, and now rise everything all up at once. Keep the chin off the chest. Exhale, arms down to your sides. And let's turn around the opposite way you normally do. Go quick, right onto your back. Heels touch, toes fall wide open, palms face up to the ceiling. All right, strong sit up, flex feet, arms overhead, cross the thumbs, tuck the chin, deep inhale, quickly dive straight for the toes, loud double exhale. So let's go ahead, turn. We're gonna come back to that front mirror, front wall in front of you, this time moving into our deepest backward bend. So we're gonna move into camel. Again, listen to your body. Each day is gonna be completely different. So you're gonna stand up tall, 6 inches between your knees, between your feet. We're gonna take both hands, wrap the hands behind your back, pinch the elbows as tight as they can get. All right, and just setting your intention, we know what comes up. Take a nice deep inhale, lift your heart up, chest up, push the hips forward, and now drop the head back. You're gonna keep pushing the hands against your hips for as long as you need the extra support. Once you have, again, your eyes to that back wall, see if we can reach. Right hand back, grab the right heel. Good, left hand back grabs the left heel. We have that grip, fingers on the insides, thumbs on the outsides. Pinch your shoulder blades towards each other and push up. Relax your throat. Look for your feet. Look for, again, your floor beneath you. And now squeeze your inner thighs towards each other and lift pubic bone up towards the ceiling. Softly suck the stomach in, create more space between your spine. And now pull, inhale, chest up, exhale, push everything forward. Change. Put one hand at a time back to the spine, lift up, sit straight back, and turn around as quickly as you can. Try to get right onto your floor. Since, again, we are back bending, try to maybe keep that lower spine closer to the floor. Create just length in the low back. All right, feel the heart beating, slow down your breathing. Let's do it again, flex feet, arms overhead, cross the thumbs, tuck the chin, inhale, breathing, dive. Quick dive, grab toes, double exhale. And let's turn maybe the opposite way you just did. Come back up, top of the mats. Second set, this is gonna be our last backward bend, so standing tall on the knees. Open up your knees, your feet 6 inches apart. Right, sit up nice and tall, wrap the hands behind your back, pinch the elbows as tight as they can get. One day they're invisible behind you. Right, take a nice deep inhale, breathing, lift your heart up, chest up, push the hips forward, exhale, drop your head back. And you want to look way back, look for the farthest thing you can find. So the hands are still on your hips, we're pushing hips up and forwards, hips up and forwards. Now look for the back wall, reach back, right hand first grabs the right heel. Left hand grabs that left heel. And now fingers on the insides, thumbs on the outsides. Keep that lower belly slightly pulled in. Good, keep pulling on your heels. And then if you're going into advanced, elbows in, walk the hands all the way up if it feels okay. And we're holding it, last chance. Suck the lower belly in. Inhale, chest up, heart up. Exhale, push hips, stomach, legs, everything forward. And let's slowly change. Come up the opposite way, taking your time. Sit straight back, turn around, lie down, Savasana. Nice, we're gonna come up. Okay, flip onto your lower back, keeping that low back on the floor, heels together, toes fall wide open, palms face up to the ceiling. Okay, and again, just letting go of any previous posture, moving forwards, and let's start to round the spine. So flex feet, arms overhead, cross the thumbs, tuck the chin, inhale, let's dive straight for the toes, loud, double exhale. So let's move into rabbits. We're gonna turn around, sit down, knees and feet together. Take the towel over your heels for a dry grip. Fingers on the insides, thumbs on the outside. Once you have that full grip, let's lean back. Okay, tuck your chin. Look for your collarbones and exhale, start to roll the body into a ball. So let's bring your eyebrows to your kneecaps, top of the head to the floor. Once the head hits the floor, very slowly begin to lift your hips up. And we're gonna lift your hips up. Good, pull the shoulders back, lift your hips up, and now walk your knees up to meet the forehead. Push your feet down, push your knees down, lift your hips up and over your shoulders. Roll that middle spine towards the wall or a mirror in front of you. And now suck your belly and suck your rib cage into your spine. Now pull, lift up, roll forward, roll forward, roll forward. Change. Hips slowly come down. Restack the spine, the vertebrae up one by one, chin off the chest last. And let's turn around, lie down, Savasana. Flip right to your back. Heels touch, toes fall wide open, palms face up to the ceiling. And let's go, flex feet, arms overhead. Cross the thumbs, tuck the chin, inhale, dive up. Straight for the toes, double exhale. And we're gonna turn around again, just the opposite way you did before. Second set, rabbit. Sit on top of your heels, good, stay with it. Let's flip the towel over your heels for a dry grip. Fingers on the insides, thumbs on the outside. Okay, we were just here before, so let's lean back, tuck your chin, suck the belly in and start to roll the body into that same compact ball. Suck your stomach in. Touch your eyebrows to your knees, top of the head to the floor. Let the head touch the floor. Let it have some weight. Now lift your hips up. Lift your hips up, walk your knees up one by one by one. Once you get into the deepest position of your posture, take a full breath into the back of your rib cage. Allow the back of your lungs to expand. Feel all that length outwards. And then as you exhale, suck the belly in and pull. Lift your hips up, roll forward, change. Slowly hips down. Stack the vertebrae, chin off the chest last. Take your towel out. Turn the opposite way you did before. Okay, just blinking your eyes, releasing any tension in the face. Let's do these final two postures, one strong set of each, all together, flex feet, arms overhead, cross the thumbs, tuck the chin, inhale, breathing, and sit up quick. Dive, loud double exhale, grab toes. So we're gonna turn around, face forward. Let's go Jenny Shirasana. So left leg in, right leg comes out to the top right corner of the mat. Let's inhale, arms up over the head, interlace all 10 fingers, reach up, turn to the right, tuck the chin, and now round up over your right toes. 10 fingers down beneath your foot, including the thumbs with your grip. And once you have that grip, we're gonna tuck the chin to the chest, touch your forehead to your knee. And if we can get your forehead to your knee, we're gonna pull the elbows down and try to really kick, try to pull that foot off the floor. Bring your left shoulder and rib cage down, roll into the middle of your legs, and now push on the top of your foot as you pull that heel off the floor at the end. Change, inhale, rise up. Let's go right leg in, left leg out. Right, and same setup, reach up, turn to the left, tuck the chin, and then round the body up and over that extended leg. Right, slowly come down, bend your knee as much as you need to, get that full grip. And then once you have that grip, start to kick and pull the foot back towards the face. One day, once that leg is locked, we pull elbows down, elbows touch the floor, pushing against the sides of the calf muscle, and then draw that right shoulder down, suck your stomach in and kick, pull the foot off the floor at the end. Change, inhale, rise up. Both feet kick forward, gonna go straight back. As soon as you tap the floor, let's inhale and dive. Straight for the toes, loud double exhale. And we take the two middle and index fingers, let's hook grip the big toes. Shimmy the hips backwards. Try to kick the feet so far forward, your ankle bones will touch side by side. Okay, keep the knees bent for as long as you need. Try to eliminate any rounding in the spine. So we're gonna draw shoulders back, chest out. Take a nice inhale, lift your chest up hard up, and exhale, start to pull. And then inhale, lengthen out of the low back. Exhale, pull, flatten the stomach to your thighs. Inhale, lengthen out of the lower back. Exhale, flatten your chest down to your knees. Again, inhale, lengthen out of your lower back, and exhale, flatten forehead to your shins. And now last one, inhale, lengthen under your lower back, and exhale, try to kick both heels off the floor at the end. And let's change, beautiful, really nice. Inhale, come all the way up. Just go straight back, arms over your head, cross the thumbs, tuck the chin, inhale, breathing, and we sit up, dive. Straight for the toes, loud double exhale. Let's quarter turn for spine twist. So facing the side wall, let's go left leg down, right leg up and across. Right arm at the base of your spine. Inhale, lift that left arm up. Cross over the knee and now push the knee back and away. Start to turn and twist your upper body around. Pull your shoulders down your spine. And try to get your chest out in front of your shoulders. So push the chest out, pull out of your middle back, lift out of that middle spine, look over the right shoulder. Take a nice inhale, suck your stomach in. Exhale, push against the knee, turn, twist back, look back, go back. Change. Unravel the opposite way. Let's go right leg comes down. And now bring the left leg up into cross. Left arm at the base of your spine. All right, inhale, right arm comes up. So really reach. Cross over the knee with the help of your tricep, push the knee back, and now turn and twist the body around, looking over your left shoulder. Okay, so look over the left shoulder, same setup, try to get your chest in front of your, again, shoulders, pull the shoulder blades tight behind of you, and now turn, twist over that left shoulder. Point the bottom foot, roll onto your left hip, suck your stomach in, and now exhale, turn and twist back, look back, go back. Change. Turn all the way around, feet to the back wall, head to the mirror in front of you. All right, and let's do this final sit-up. So gather everything that you have. Let's flex feet, arms overhead, cross the thumbs, tuck the chin, deep inhale, and we dive. Loud, double exhale, grab toes, let's turn around. All right, we start to clear out anything else that's still lingering or hanging out, any leftover toxins or stale air. So we're gonna sit where it's comfortable. If you're sitting on your heels, just bring the arms right in front of you, tips of the fingers touch the tops of your kneecaps. Right, anywhere else, the arms go right behind you just to support your spine. So relax the stomach. Okay, only thing that moves is the belly from the breath. Let's start with your exhale, begin. exhale, 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 exhale. In, in, in. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Clear everything all the way out. Seal out your practice. Okay, thanking yourself for always just showing up, doing what you can. And once you have that, let's try to get right into the final savasana. So flip to your back once you're ready. Let's have feet to the back wall, head towards that mirror in front of you. Okay, and we take some time here in our final posture, our final savasana, allowing the body just to now take in all the benefits from each posture. It's worked so hard throughout. Okay, 60 minutes of continuous movement. Okay, now a few moments of continuous relaxation. Okay, spreading out your arms and your legs if you haven't already. Closing your eyes. Okay, and just letting go of anything that you no longer need, physically, emotionally. All right, start to deepen your breathing. All right, you can allow the lips to kind of splice open, relaxing the jaw. All right, and just starting to feel the back of the head become heavier against the floor. The back of the shoulders, the back of your hands, the back of your heels.